In just 1 week, the streets of downtown Miami will be filled with over 20,000 runners from all 50 states and more than 80 countries as the 2018 FitBit Miami Marathon and Half Marathon takes place for the 16th year with additional races and events for the whole family. Here with all the details and some firsthand knowledge of what it takes to run a marathon are Frankie Ruiz, co-founder of the Miami Marathon, and marathon runner herself, Lourdes Lawrence. Great to have both of you with us today.
Thank you.
All right, so Frankie, we were talking earlier. I'm a little intimidated. I told him I spin. I thought that would be very impressive. He's like, yeah, whatever.
That's not true.
So Miami Marathon, 16th year. This is so cool that it's had such longevity and just continues to get bigger and bigger every year, right?
Yeah, no, we're excited because we have a new partner,
Fitbit.
Yeah, we haven't had a partner since about 4 years. Everybody still calls it ING, but now it's the Fitbit Miami Marathon. So we're really excited about coming around on our 16th year.
So. And people get to use their Fitbits, correct? Like, there's a connectivity there with your Fitbit and the marathon. Yep. Tell us about that.
Sure, yeah, we've got different split mats along the way. They're going to be relatable to your Fitbit every 5 kilometers, using apps and all sorts of tech stuff that if I get into, I'll probably confuse myself talking about. But it's certainly not just timing yourself anymore.
Right. All right, and why do you think the marathon has the legs, if you will, that it does, that it continues to grow each year and is so popular? What is it about marathon running that really is so popular these days?
I mean, I'll talk specifically about Miami. I think Miami has an allure in January that very few places in the U.S. can offer, and I think our attraction for Latin American runners that find this to be second home and in some cases first home makes it an exciting destination. But running in South Florida has been booming now for, I mean, it'd say almost 20 years.
You know, yeah. So. Well, and Lourdes, you're one of those who sort of jumped on that bandwagon and really enjoy it. So tell us your story. I know that you've said you were athletic in high school, and then you had your children, which a lot of us ladies do, and we don't exercise after that. And so how did you get back into the running or get into it in the first place?
Well, my husband, my lovely husband, registered me for a obstacle course race. He's like, you're doing this.
Wow.
You are an athlete and you're going to do it. Mm-hmm. So starting line, he gives me a kiss and he says,
so you hadn't
goodbye.
Trained for this?
Oh, no. Maybe like a month or two, you know, maybe a couple push-ups, sit-ups.
Oh,
I'm like, yeah. I got this. Starting line, he gives me a kiss. See you at the finish line. Boom. He takes off. I'm like, oh, goodness, I'm by myself. Finished the Spartan. It was the super in Miami. Mm-hmm. And I was in disbelief that I even finished it. All in one place. So I said, you know what? I need to go back. That competitive edge, that sense of accomplishment that one has, you know, it didn't fade. And it's still in there in your heart. So that's how I started. And I said, every time I would run to an obstacle course, I said, I like running.
Wow.
I really like this. Yeah. And I want to do this. So I started with 5Ks, then jumped up to the halves. And then there was that perfect storm challenge that Frankie came up with.
What is that?
It's two triathlons, Olympic distance, international distance, three half marathons, a 10K, a 5K, and then the full marathon.
Wow.
All within 6 months. And it's just exciting to every single time you've hit that finish line, you're like, okay, I have four more to go. I got this. Let's not get injured. Let's, you know, nutrition, hydration, you know, the whole thing. And you know, my boys were supporting me, my two big boys and my husband, big support, cooking dinner. And
you were the only woman.
Yeah, and I was the only woman that finished. There were six of us, thank you. There were six of us that finished, and I was the only female that finished, which it's very exciting.
That's a huge accomplishment.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Frankie, for somebody who's watching this and is getting inspired and says, you know, maybe I can do this too, what does it take to kind of get to that point?
I think the first thing I would invite them to do is come check out the finish line. Come out and be a spectator that day so you can see that everybody's not Kenyan, right? Even though we have 8 registered Kenyan runners, so there will be some fast times. But everyone doesn't look like you would think an Olympian runner looks like. And I think that makes it very, very human. And then the next step I would say is go out to a run club, find a neighbor that runs. Runners are very inviting to their community. Mm-hmm. And then from there, find a training program and maybe at your local running store and then sign up to do next year's race.
Do you think a lot of it's mental? Because you and I were talking too about how when you're younger, sometimes running's looked at as a punishment. You have to run laps because you got to practice mm-hmm. late. Something like that.
100%. It's definitely a mental thing, and I find it funny. Like some of my high school friends were football players, and all of a sudden mm-hmm. now they're runners because they realize they can't, you know, put the pads on and the helmet on. So it's something that some people discover later on in life that they like.
Yeah.
So don't completely put the X on it because you had a bad experience when you were younger. You know, we like to say we're gonna get you to like something you didn't know you liked so much.
I was a swimmer. I started off as a swimmer.
Yeah.
So I never thought that I would really like running so much. You know, when I'm tired, I tell my husband I'm gonna go for a run. He looks at me and says, "Didn't you just finish telling me you're tired?" No, it's my alone time. It's my time to just go out there and run.
This is Miami.
Yes.
364 days if you get hit by a hurricane.
It's great outside.
You know?
Thank you so much, both of you,
for
being here. And good luck with the marathon.
Thank you.
Very exciting. The 2018 FitBit Miami Marathon and Half Marathon takes place Sunday, January 28th in downtown Miami. For more information, visit themiamimarathon.com. As always, we're going to have all this information for you on our Facebook page at Your South FL.